Good morning, students. Thank you for being with me again in our math online class. I am Maafin, teacher of class 3 from Milestone Preparatory KG School. Welcome in all our math online class. Students, I hope all of you are safe and sound by the grace of Almighty Allah. Alhamdulillah, I am also fine. So let's start our class. You know, student, that already we have completed our first term math syllabus. And now we are starting our second term math syllabus. And we have started a new chapter, isn't it? So what was our previous class? The name of our previous topic was deviation. Yes, and I know that already you have learned the basic information about this chapter. So let's start ask you some question from our previous chapter. That was division. Now students, can I ask you some question from our previous chapter? Yes. So can you tell me what is called division? Yes. Very good. Division means distribute something among two or more than two groups, that is called division. Again, I am telling it for you. And now, look, I am giving an example here. That is, look at the board. There are 10 chocolates. And I want to distribute this 10 chocolate among two groups. So, how many chocolates will each group get? Yes, for finding out this question answer, we have to use here division method, because there is a clue word distributed, isn't it, my dear students? So if I do the division here, so I have to write 10 divided by what? 2. So I got the answer here 5. So each group will get 5 chocolates. Is it clear to you? Now? Yes. Now, tell me second question for you. What is called divisor? Yes, very good. The number by whose division is done? We call it divisor. Okay. The number by which division is done is called divisor. Okay, my dear students. So, let's start our today's topic. Today we learn how to do the division. Okay. So everybody take out your CW copy, book and diary in front of you. Okay. And be attentive. Whenever I will make you understand, then you have to be attentively listen to me. Okay. Students, today's our topic is division, and from page 67 I will show you from problem number 3, 6 and 12 number at first. Okay, so get ready for the class. My dear students, I have written here our first problem 6. 85 divided by 6 equal to, we have to find out what? Yes, quotient. We have to find out the answer of division. And you know, answer of division is called what? Quotient. And look, here, this is side by side division. So, we have to show here the rough work also. And tell me now, here, 85 is, this number is called what here? Yes, here, 85 is our dividend. Because we know the number which we have to be divided, that is called dividend. So we have to divide it here 85. And this is our division sign, you know. And 6 is our divisor here. Because by 6 we have to divide 85. So at first we have to show the rough word. And you know that whenever we have to start the division, then we have to follow some steps of division. I will show you. At first I am showing here rough word. That is 6 is our divisor and 85 is our dividend. That's why I have written 85 in the middle portion. Okay, my dear student. So we are starting now doing the division. But before going to start division, let's have a look the steps of division. We have to follow these steps whenever we do the division. That is, first number is compare. Okay. So we have to follow this step. Compare. Compare means what? Look, my dear student, they are divided. There is 2 digits, 8 and 5. So at first, what should I do? At first, we have to think like that. That we have to take 1 digit. Okay. Here 1 digit is 8. How can you compare? We have to compare this 1 digit with this divisor. Okay. So if it is this digit is greater than divisor, then we can take at first 1 digit. Okay. This is our compare part, and we have to follow this step at first. That at first we will take 2 digit together, or we will take 1 digit too at first. That's why we have to do the comparison here. And look here, 8 is what? 8 is greater than 6. So no need to take 2 digit here together. At first, by this 6, we have to divide this 8 1 digit. And that's why what we have to do next step, we have to read out the multiplication table. And here our divisor is 6. That's why we have to read out the multiplication table of 6. So for division, multiplication table is very necessary item for you. Without multiplication table, we cannot do the division properly. Okay, my dear? So there is a rules also, you have to follow that once. That is, sometimes if you read out the multiplication table, sometimes it can be matched with our digit and sometimes it cannot be matched our digit. So in that case, what should we do? In that case, we have to follow the rules that we have to take the nearest number of the first digit of dividend. Okay, my dear? Always keep in mind that sometimes whenever read out the multiplication table, sometimes it cannot be matched up with our dividend number or digit. That's why that time what should we do? We have to take the nearest number of this digit. But we cannot cross the over number of this digit. We cannot cross, we cannot take the more number of this digit. Okay, let's, I will make you understand now. Step by step. Now look, I am comparing the number. Look, here is at first there is a digit 8. So compare the digit with this divisor, that is 6. So what should I do? I can take 1 digit at first, because this digit is what? This digit is greater than divisor. So now I compare it. So at first I will work with 1 digit. Okay. So read out 6 times 7. 6 zeros are 0, 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are what? They are telling it here. 6 twos are 12. So it cross our digit, because we need 8. But in 6 times table, look at there, there is no 8 in the 6 times table. So it cannot be match up. So what should we do? We will take 6 threes are 12 here. No, my dear students, we cannot take the more digit than 8. We can take the nearest number of 8. That means I have to take 6 ones are 6. Okay, so I am writing here 6 ones are 6. Okay, now I am taking the nearest number of 8, that is 6 ones are 6. So what should I do now? 6 ones are 6. Now what should I do? Our third step is subtraction. Now we will do here the subtraction. Look, I am doing the subtraction. It is 8 and it is 6. Okay. So 8 minus 6, what will be there? I am not showing here the subtraction sign. But we have to keep in mind that we have to do here the subtraction. So 8 minus 6, it will be what? 2. Okay. Now look, 2 and our divisor is 6. So what should I do? I can divide these 2 by this 6. No, my dear student, in our dividend part, another number is left here, that is 5. Now we have to bring down this 5 with this 2. Then I got here 25, isn't it? So this 25 now I will divide by this 6. So again we have to read out 6 times table. But keep in mind, we cannot cross 25. We have to take in the nearest number. If there is no 25 in 6 times table, we cannot cross 25. We have to take the nearest number of 25. So again read out 6 times table with me. 6 zeros are 0, 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18, 6 fours are 24, 6 fives are 30. Oh, 6 fives I got here 30, but I cannot take here 6 fives are 30 because 30 is greater number than 25. So I have to take nearest number. Here look, put it on the nearest number, 24. 24 is the nearest number of 25. So I have to take this number. So I read out 6 fours are 24. Now what should I do? Again I have to do the subtraction here, our next step. So look, I am doing the subtraction, and you know which place we have to start the subtraction? Yes, always 1's place. So 5 minus 4, what will be there? Subtract by your finger line. Yes, 4. I need 1 finger line to reach 5. So it will be 1. Now go to the next. 2 minus 2. 2 minus 2. Is there anything? No, my dear student. 2 minus 2, it will be 0. Okay. Look, there is only 1 here. And I cannot divide this 1 by this 6. And look, there is no number left in the dividend part, so that I can bring down here. So this one is our reminder. This part is our is what? Reminder part. And our result and answer of division is 14. Okay. So this is called why reminder? Because after doing the subtraction, we get here 1. This is not our dividend part. This is our reminder part. Because after doing the subtraction, we got here 1. So how can I write the answer now? I can write here our quotient, Q-O-T-I-E-N-T, quotient. Our quotient is 14, and I have to write here also reminder. Reminder, our reminder is what? We got here 1. Okay, my dear student, after doing the division, we have to write the answer like this way, that we got the quotient at 14 and our remainder is 1. So have you understood, my dear students, that how can I do the division? And we have to keep in mind the step of division. We have to follow the step of division always. Okay. Now let's start our next problem. Now students, I will show you another problem from problem number 312. So look at the board, I have written the question here. This 97 is our dividend, we know, and this 8 is our divisor. Okay, so what should we do? We have to follow the step at first, that there are 2 digits of dividend. So at first we have to compare 1 digit with the divisor. And if the first digit, we have to start from the left side, you know, and this is our first digit, 9. So compare the number, first digit with this divisor. So 9, what we got here? That 9 is greater than 8. So we will take at first 1 digit. Okay, we will not take 2 digit together. So this 1 is greater than our divisor. So at first we have to divide 1 digit by our divisor. And our divisor is here 8. So we have to read out now 8 times 7, because our second step is multiplication table we have to read out. So read 8 times table, and can you remember I told you before that in 8 times table it can be match up with the number and it cannot be match up with our dividend number. So that time what should we do? We have to take the nearest number of the digit. And now look at the times table of 8. 8 zeros are 0, 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16. So 8, if I take 8 twos are 16, then it will be cross our 9. 8 twos are 16. We cannot take this 8 twos are 16. So here the nearest number of 9 is what? 8. So we have to take this nearest number. If it will not be match up with this digit, so we have to take the nearest number of the digit. And here the nearest number of 9 is 8. So I can write like this way, 8 ones are 8. Now what should we do? I told you before, yes, in that case we have to do the subtraction here. The next step, our subtraction. So do the subtraction, 9 minus 8, what will be there? Very good, yes, there will be 1. Now, what should we do? By this 8, can I divide 1? We cannot divide 1 by 8. That's why we have to now follow next step. Now we have to bring down the next part of our dividend. And this 7 is our another dividend part, and it, we have to bring down it here. Okay. So I got here what? 17. Okay. So this 17 we have to divide by our divisor 8. So we have to again read out here the 8 times table. So read out 8 times table. 8 zeros are 0, 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24. So there is no 17 in 8 times table. So what should I do now? Yes, that's why we have to take the nearest number of 17. The nearest number of 17 is what? Look at the chart. Yes, the nearest number of 17 is 16. We cannot take the more than 17 number. We have to take the nearest number of 17. So I can write here 8 to the 16. Okay, my dear. So now what should I do? Again, I have to do the subtraction here. Yeah. So we have to start from the ones place. 7 minus 6, what will be there? 1. 7 minus 6, it will be 1. And look, there is no number left in the dividend part. So I cannot bring down any number here. So this is our remainder part. We know that after doing the subtraction, we got remainder. The left number after doing the subtraction is called remainder. So here we got the quotient 12, and this is our remainder part. Okay. And we have to write the answer like this way, that we got the quotient 12 and our remainder is there, remainder is 1. So like this way, my dear student, we have to complete it, we have to complete our division. Okay, so we have to follow the step also. So now I am starting the next number from the next page. Now students, from page 69 I will show you another two problems, from problem number 1, 6 and 13 number. So I have written the question 6 number, 835 divided by 9, and we have to find out the quotient. Okay, so look, this is also side by side division, so that's why we have to show rough word. And I am writing the rough word, and you know this 835 is our dividend because this number we have to divide it, and 9 is our divisor. Okay, so now I am starting division. What should I do now? You know, from the left side we have to compare the one digit at first. So here, there from the left side, 8 is our first digit. So look students, 8 is smaller than our divisor. So we cannot take here one digit. We have to take here then two digits together from the left side. So I take 83 together, and you know the times table of 9. So here is the chart of 9 times table. Read out the 9 times table with me. 9 zeros are 0, 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, 9 threes are 27, 9 fours are 36, 9 fives are 45, 9 sixes are 54, 9 sevens are 63, 9 eights are 72, 9 nines are 81, 9 tens are 90. So I cannot take here 9 tens are 90 because it will be cross our 83. So I told you that we have to take nearest number of the dividend. So 83 nearest number in the 9 times table is 81. So I have to take 9 times are 81. And now what should I do? I have to do the subtraction here. Look, 3 minus 1. It is very easy. 1, 2, 3. So I need 2 here. And I cannot do the division here now because 2 is smaller than 9. And our another part of dividend is left here. So I have to bring down this side here and I have to write here. Look, now it will become 25. So this 25 we will divide by 9. So read out again the times table of 9. Look at the chart. 9 zeros are 0, 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, 9 threes are 27. So my dear students, here I cannot take 9 threes are 27 because it will cross our 25. So we have to take the nearest number of 25. So nearest number of 25 is what here? 9 twos are 18. So I have to write here 9 twos are 18. So now what should I do? We have to do a subtraction, you know. So do the subtraction from the ones place. Here it will be 5 and here is a 8. So my students, you know, smaller number from greater number we cannot subtract. So we think we have to borrow 10 from the 10 space. So this ones place will become what? Get 10. 10 plus 5, 15. So 15 minus 8, it will be what? 15 minus 8, count by finger line, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So I need 7. 7 here, and as 10's place gave 1 10 to the 1's place, so what should I do? It will become 1. We have to keep in mind 1 minus 1, there will be nothing. So this is our quotient, that is 92, and this 7 is our remainder, and there is no number left in the dividend part that we can bring down. So this is our answer. So we got the quotient here, we got the quotient 92 here, and our remainder is 7. Our remainder is 7 because the left number after doing the subtraction we can call it remainder. You know it very well. Okay, so you can write like this way. Now I am starting the next problem. Okay, look at the board now. This is problem number 13. I have written here the question, and look, this is not side by side division. So no need to show here the rough one. Okay. So look, my dear student, I am studying our division. And you know that we have to compare the digit at first. And at first, from the right side, we have to compare one digit of the dividend. So here, look, there is 7, first digit from the left side. And here, our divisor is 5. So look, this 7 is greater than 5. So what should we do? We can take 1 digit here. That's why we have to take 1 digit at first. And we have to read out 5 times table, you know. So read out 5 times table. Look at the chart. 5 zeros are 0, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. So no need to go up to the 5 to the 10 because we cannot take care 5 to the 10 because it will be cross 7. So we have to take the nearest number of 7. And in the 5 times table, the nearest number of 7 is 5. So I will take 5 ones are 5. And now, what should I do? I do the subtraction, you know. 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5 will be what? 7 minus 5, it will be count by a finger line. 7 minus 5, it will be 2. Yes, now, these 2 I cannot divide by 5. So I have to bring down here, this 2 number is left in the dividend part. So at first I will bring down this 0 with this 2. So it will become now 20. So this 20 we have to divide by 5. So read out again 5 times table. 5 zeros are 0, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20. Oh my god, I got here the 20. It will match up with our 20. So what should I do? I will write here 5 fours are 20. So my dear student, if I do the subtraction here, there will be nothing. 20 minus 20 match up. So what should I do now? Our division has completed here. No. Another number is left in the dividend part. That is 5. And we have to bring down this 5 here. Here is nothing, 0. But we have to bring down this dividend part. Okay. Now this 5, I have to divide by this 5. So it will be very easy. Read out 5 times table. One time it will go in the 5. Look, 5 ones are 5. It can go once time in the 5. So I can write 5 ones are 5. How many times it will go in the 5? 1 times. Okay, 5 ones are 5. Now what should I do? Do the subtraction. 5 minus 5, what will be there? Is there anything? Nothing. There will be 0. 5 minus 5, it will be 0. So our quotient is here. I got 141 and this 0 is our nothing. No reminder is there. Okay. So we got the answer here. Quotient. Is there any reminder? My dear students, no. There is no reminder in this problem. But we have to go step by step. And reminder will be 0. Reminder is 0 here. Okay. So like this way we have to complete this number. And I hope so that if you go step by step whenever you want to do the division, then you can do by yourself to do so many number of divisions. And for division, I told you before that you have to learn the multiplication table properly. Okay, otherwise maybe our answer will be wrong. So we have to memorize the times table at home every day. Now students, it's time for taking feedback from you. So get ready for the question. First question for you. What is called the answer of division? Okay, very good. Right answer. The answer of division is called quotient. Very good. So now get ready for the next question. Look, I have written an example for you. I have written 3 parts of number here. That is 64 divided by 8 equal to 8. So students, can you tell me in these 3 parts of number, which part is called dividend here? Yes, here our answer will be 64. It is our dividend because this number we have to divide. Okay, so now it's time for diary writing. Get ready with your diary. Write down the diary. Do from page 68, problem number 1, 3 and 5 number. And do from page 69, problem number 1, 14 and 16. Okay? So I hope all of you have finished your writing. So students, no more today. Keep on practicing math every day at your home so that you can get more marks in math subject. So see you in our next math class. Till then, take care and bye bye.